We're gonna finish up Dragon Age Origins tonight. Tonight's the night. Gonna beat this game once and for all. Anyway, I'll be right back. Just give me a second to share the stream. Okay, I'm back. Let's beat the game. Let's beat it already. Been a long stream. Been playing this for weeks and weeks. I think the longest stream I've done. Actually, I've done like a couple of really long streams, but the ones that have like been long in terms of the number of days I've been playing it, I think maybe the longest was Vampire. Vampire the Masquerade, or is it called? No, Vampire. Yeah, Vampire the Masquerade Bloodlines. That was a great game. So underrated, but I kind of know why. It isn't as popular as it should be, because when it was first released, it was really buggy. So because of that, it didn't get stellar reviews because of all the bugs. But, you know, if you play it now, if you include all of the official patches and then all the fan patches and then all the extra fan stuff fans have made, it's actually a really, really good game. So good that I would like to play it again one day. Offline, probably. Maybe even online. Who knows? We can always stream games that we've beaten before, but, you know, typically I do like to play new games. But, I mean, definitely shorter games we can easily stream again. Like Mario Bros. 3. It'd be nice to play that game again. Or I should beat Mario World. If I do play it, I would like to 100% it, though. Alright, where are we? Where are we? Oh, here we are. Okay, so I remember where we last left off. We need to go through here and just cast a whole bunch of AoE spells. Like, this is pretty tough. I kept dying here and I got frustrated. We just gotta go with the AoE, just like hammer them with AoE spells. And kinda not stop. Kinda. Just kinda keep going there.
Darkspawn approach. Watch for their blood.
Well, first things first. I'm gonna cast it right away, in fact. Right here.
Arm the danger.
Gonna do a little bit of overlap here. First things first. Let's put on the old mass rejuvenation. We'll do do one of these. Tempest. Well, hold on. Oops. We got it. We gotta use. Oh, wait. That. Use this. Just gotta keep up the offense here.
Let's get started.
We'll give her a greater, maybe. Alright, we'll go with the greater Lyrum Po. Run, 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 run. We gotta keep it up. She doesn't have a lot of AoE spells. Not over yet.
This should be easy enough.
I'm actually not really sure what to do here.
You'll pay for that.
I'm in a really bad spot. I'm not really sure how to get through this. All right, we need to maybe use some items on the on our other guys. That's the only thing I can really think of. Oh boy, it's just stupidly hard right now. Let me think. What should we do? What should we do? Well, let me take a sip of my beverage. I think I'll cast like stone, like some kind of protective item on my tank guys. I don't know, they're just not using their health poultices fast enough. And you know, the funny thing is they've been going through that shit like candy. I mean, they're healing themselves, but they're not doing it fast enough.
Darkspawn, destroy the beast. Right.
Why is he stunned? Where is she? She died already. There she is. Damn it! Bullshit. Let's try this. Let's do a little healing. Little group healing. I can't. Okay, this time we're gonna use this. Once again. Can't see.
Oh, right.
think we got it. Finally. Holy crap. Okay, yeah, the rock salves, they helped a lot. They helped a lot. Alright, let's save. Holy shit, that was insane. Oh boy. The rock salves is what turned the tide of the battle. Hear like horns and things. We're close to the end. I'm just checking these bodies. I mean, we don't really need anything here, really. The only thing I might need are health potions. Concentrate venom. I don't know. Don't know how useful that might be. Alright. Here we are. Fort Dracon. Gain Mactir. There's all kinds of DLC where you can actually do more quests with your buddies and with your party. Okay, it's auto saving. Hold on 1 minute, I'll be right back. Okay, I'm back. Sorry about that. Alright, hopefully the game won't be too much longer. Hopefully there won't be too much more left. I can't remember exactly how much more there is, but we should be pretty close to the end. We're in the final area. This is Fort Dracon. Just take a quick look inside of these things. Here's a chest that I can't open. So infuriating to see all that all the time. You basically have to keep Leliana with you or be a rogue in order to open those stupid things. Pile of books. I don't need a pile of fucking books. No need. But what I do need to do is, okay, we're gonna do some herbalism stuff here. It's a good thing I brought along extras. Because we absolutely need to make more. We're running low on flasks though, so I'll just kinda stop there. Hopefully we have enough. Yeah, that's like 79. That should be enough. It's a good thing I brought extras. Otherwise we would have been in a bad situation. You don't want to be in a situation like that, where you don't have what you need. Especially for the final battle. Oh, hey, Nilavani. I'm glad you can make it. We're in the final stretch here. We're in the final area. Final... You're gonna go up against the final boss pretty soon. I'm not really sure how much further it's gonna be. Damn it! Come on! Yeah, we're pretty close to the end. Yeah, we're really close. Okay. I was having so much trouble with the previous area. I kept dying because they kept on throwing so many enemies at me all at once. I had to use two rock salves on the dwarf and the golem. That helped out a lot because they kept on dying, but with the rock salve they were able to tank for me pretty well. I actually heard that, you know, the best way to play this is just to have a melee character lead the way. That's the good thing about this game, you can actually just have a melee. You can take control of anyone. So if I just control this guy and have him lead.
These things stink when you squish them. All right, I shall do it. As you wish.
Let's do this.
This should be easy enough.
Wow, the lag. They're beginning to actually become kind of difficult. Kind of challenging. It's not like the pushover that it used to be, like, they're actually starting to be a little dangerous. Let me guess, this is locked, yeah. Okay. Corpse go.
Unliving wretches.
I'm just trying to check to see if they have any, like, health items. Because that's really what I need. Okay, yeah, that's... Oh. What? That... I can't... Cannot allow that to happen. Gonna have to destroy all of it. Yeah, we definitely need any kind of health potions that we can find. I did, luckily all those health potions, well, the ingredients, they really came in handy. Yeah, they came in handy because, like, in the last battle, they were going through health items so fast. So, to go into the final area without any health items is such a bad idea. Luckily, we do have, 75 of these, 1 of these, 8 of these, and what is that, 9 of those? So that should be enough for the rest of the game. At least I hope so. Yeah, there's nothing good. Anything? Yeah, it should be enough, I hope. In terms of lyrium, that we're kind of running low on. We have 37 of these, 8. Assuming that the final boss is coming up really soon, it should be enough. I better save. You need a lot of lyrium because these guys, they go through it so quickly. It doesn't matter how much mana points I have. It doesn't. They go through it too quickly. I'm actually kind of confused here. Where do I go? I gotta go back, maybe? Wait. I gotta go back. So how you doing, Nilavani? Hope everything's going well.
Enchantment?
It's this guy.
Enchantment!
I think this should be good. Yeah. I mean, there are better weapons. I know, like, on my first playthrough, I had better weapons than this. Like, I had one that had, like, at least 4 of these things. I think maybe you can even get more, but oh well. This is the best thing I have found for that guy. Doing good? Any news to report? Oh yeah, that Cuban Beast, he left the Discord. It was kind of funny. Because he posted a fake quote of Hitler. And like I spent like literally 2 seconds on Googling that quote, and I found the Snopes article that proved that it was bullshit. I don't know, why don't people ever check their sources instead of spreading, like, this is fake news. Instead of checking sources, they just spread fake news, and they keep on accusing the left of spreading fake news. No. The biggest perpetrators of fake news always comes from the right. So that guy, he left the Discord. I guess he couldn't take the logic. The rationality that was being displayed. Oh well. Memes weren't even funny. Yeah, I mean, like, he was taking that quote seriously, like, as if this is proof that Hitler was a socialist. No, it was a fake quote. I hated how people keep posting those stupid quotes just because there's an image and a photograph of the guy. Then, like, people just assume that he said that. No! How gullible can you get? Gullibility up the ass. Just because someone posts a photo and then a little blurb saying whatever and then it attributes it to the person in the photo does not mean that person said that. How gullible can you be? Check your sources. But they never check their sources. They just spread it because it sounds good, because it fits their agenda and their preconceived biases. This is like a little maze.
Dark spot. Destroy the beam.
Oh. Traps. Several injuries. Let's use a injury kit. And we need to use this.
Very well.
Okay, good. Man, why are there so many traps here? Shit. I better save. Recast everything.
As you wish.
And this is broken. Okay. Let me save. Jeez, how much further is it? Let's check the map. Let's see if there's like an easy way through all this. No, there's no easy way. Too bad Cuba sends all their right-wingers to America. Cuban Americans will vote for Trump at the same rate as white Americans did. Really? Yeah. Because the thing is, everyone who likes socialism and communism, they don't leave Cuba. So there's a selective process going on there. Everyone who leaves is naturally going to be right wing. And a lot of them are white. So they don't suffer from oppression against racial minorities because to Americans, they look as white as anyone else. So they naturally gravitate towards the Republican Party and conservatism. Because they don't suffer from any of the ill effects of racial discrimination against racial minorities. You don't even know that they're Cuban unless they say so. They have to say they are Cuban in order for you to know that they are Cuban.
Darkspawn approach. Watch for their blood.
Holy crap, why do they keep dying? No! This went badly. Alright, let's just reload. It doesn't go well. If they're all bunched up, it goes well. If they're not bunched up, it does not go well. They need to be bunched up. Long load time, sorry. Maybe I should go in there with this guy first. Alright, first things first. I should probably change it. Why does it keep saving? It already saved. Whoops. I should really change these things. Oh, here he has that assigned. In that case... Alright. Oh wait, here he has... Oh jeez. Here he has that assigned. Okay. Assign this. There. Okay, good. We're gonna lead the way with this guy.
Ooh, these things stink when you squish them. Very well.
Okay. Well, it depends on the tactics. Tactics can make or break a battle.
Surely there are better uses for our time.
Pretty much have to save after every battle now. It's the only way to get through this because it's becoming pretty tough. Which makes sense because this is the final dungeon. Okay, rooftop. This should be it, I hope. We've been fighting through so much, some pretty hard battles. I'm ready to finish this up. Yeah, but it was a good game. I just wish I didn't have to play on the PlayStation 3. Too many random freezes, too many technical issues. Okay, here we go. Mods. No freezes. More content. Hey, Tiggy! How you doing? Glad you can make it. Alright, final battle. Okay, let's cast Rejuvenation right at the beginning. Hey, Tiggy, what's up? I'm glad you can make it. How are you doing?
Great job!
Let's get started. As you wish.
Let's go with the lightning storm first. Tempest. Gonna go with Blizzard.
As you wish.
Bring a little bit of this.
As you
use rock salve on him as well.
Armed and dangerous, ready for action.
Let us end this.
Hey, Trutka, what's up? Glad you can make it.
As you wish.
Firestorm. Inferno. This guy, he keeps on running around, that's the problem. It makes him a little harder. Well, a lot harder. Can't use AoE spells on him effectively. Damn it, stop moving around, you fuck!
Let's get
started. Idiot didn't put the death hex on. Yeah, dragon. This is the final boss.
I shall do it.
Ha! You're getting sloppy!
Idiots. No. Out of here. this exactly? There's too many of them. How the fuck am I supposed to do this? I don't have any idea. How do I do that? Because I'm barely doing any damage to that fucking dragon. Like, because I can't even hit it with AoE attacks because it keeps jumping around. And so it's useless. There might be some kind of item I can use. And it seems like the dragon is magic resistant because I'm not doing enough damage. I don't know how the fuck that... I can try use some more items. But honestly, like, I wasn't prepared for this spike in difficulty. Like, there should have been more preparation beforehand to, like, ease me into this. Because I have no idea how to really beat him as it is right now. I can use these rock salves, that'll help. What does this do? Alright, I'll try this. See? It just jumps somewhere else. All this do? Yeah. I don't know what kind of damage it does. I could use some of these things if I knew what damage it was actually doing. What does this do?
Who shall I crush?
They'll never know what hit.
Morgan's an idiot. She just stands right there, takes the hit, instead of running away like she's supposed to. I have to constantly control them because they're gonna die otherwise. Hold on, I have a better idea. Hold on. He's running away now. Here comes the hard part.
Let's get started.
No, you moron! Buddies, I see some of them there. I can't keep up with this. I don't know how to get through this part. Too many of them come at once and from all sides. That's bullshit. Alright, I have an idea. As soon as they come, I'm gonna hit the two meat shield. I'll probably hit everyone with the rock salve. I mean, it'll slow them down, but they can at least tank a lot more. I might not need a rock salve in the beginning, we'll see. There's just too many of them.
Thank you.
issues.
Now we get our hands dirty.
Why doesn't this guy ever heal? still not done yet. Yet? There's still some goons over there. Don't stop! Can't level up in combat. Still nail this guy? He's right there. Sick of your bullshit. Now he's coming in. Where'd it go? Where is it? Where is it? Oh, there it is. No, you don't. All right. Damn it. No, I can't.
This should be easy enough.
How the fuck did that happen? I should have given her a revive. She doesn't have revive, does she? She has group heal.
I shall do it.
So close. All right, that's it. Thank you, Nilavani. Thank you, Chartka. was pretty fucking hard. That was quite a difficulty spike. I nearly died at the end. I'd lost the only guy who can revive. I should have given Morrigan revive, actually. Even if she can't revive people on her own.
And then,
good,
it was over. With the Archdemon dead, Darkspawn Horde quickly crumbled. Most fled back into the Deep Roads. They would remain a threat in the years to come. But the Blight had been ended before it had truly begun. Ferelden had been saved, and the entire kingdom rose up to joyously greet its queen.
Maybe, but it's a lot harder for a mage.
But at what cost?
I had two mages. I don't know. It was a pretty big difficulty spike. It wasn't a 100-hour game. This is like a 40-hour game. But like, yeah, if you do a lot of side quests and things, then you could spend quite a bit of time with it.
My friends, we are gathered to celebrate those responsible for our victory. Of those who stood against the Darkspawn siege of Denerim, there is one in particular who deserves commendation. The one who led the charge against the Archdemon and killed it remains with us still. An inspiration to all he saved that day. Ladies and gentlemen, I present the hero of Ferelden.
That's
the first
right.
Grey Warden to defeat the Blight since Garahel 4 centuries ago.
Including DLC, yeah.
Grey Warden, it is hard to imagine how you could have aided Ferelden more. I think it only appropriate that I return the favor. Is there any boon you might request of Ferelden's queen?
Let's see. Title and riches. Circle of Mage I'd be given its independence. I wanted to marry her. Title and riches to go with it, yeah.
My father's Tairnir in Gwarren stands empty, as does his estate, and I gladly pass both on to you. Let it also be known that the Arling of Amaranthine, once the land of Arl Hau, is now granted to the Grey Wardens. There they can rebuild, following the example of those who went before them. What are your plans? Will you remain with the Grey Wardens?
I tend to find Morrigan.
My impression was that she didn't want to be found. But I understand.
Absolution.
There is a group of eager Ferelden citizens waiting outside to get a look at their hero. I suggest you make at least a brief appearance before they storm the gate. Just tell the guard at the door when you are ready.
Honestly, I kind of wish that Alistair was king instead of her, because she did screw us over. Alistair never fucked us over. Let's see. Well, we don't need to. Wait a minute. We can talk to people, can't we? We can talk to Loghain. Here's Leliana.
So here we are. The conquering hero has won the day, and now he takes his bow and exits the stage. A fine ending. I don't know. I haven't read that part yet, have I? You'll have to tell me. Oh, is that how it is?
Yeah.
You know, I can't help now but think of my vision. The Maker sent me to help you, and look what you did. It's a miracle. It truly is. I've been asked by the Chantry to return to the Urn of Sacred Ashes. I need to make sure it's protected. Maybe pilgrims can even begin going there again. Of course I do. I can't think of anything more important. I can give something back to the entire world. It will be a grand adventure. I hope I will see you before I leave, to say goodbye. At any rate, you should get back to the celebration. We can speak another time.
Let's see if there's anyone else we can talk to. Zevran, I don't really care. Liliana. Yeah. Let's talk to Logan a little bit.
So it appears that Riordan was wrong. I find it difficult to believe that he deliberately misled us. Have you another explanation for what happened? True. So many things were different this time, I understand. Perhaps this was different as well. Still, the Orlesian Grey Wardens have been persistent in their questions. I intend to keep any thoughts on the matter to myself. I understand you're leaving soon. I've been tapped to lead the Grey Warden recruitment efforts here in Ferelden. Honora's influence, no doubt. I would have preferred she not interfered.
You deserve far worse.
Tell her that. Let us put an end to the chatter here. I'm sure neither of us has the stomach for it. Go and return to your celebration. Regardless of what I might think, you ended the Blight. You deserve your accolades.
Alright. Everyone else, don't really care. Zevran, we never really... too close to that guy. We can talk to Ogryn a little bit.
Humans have a better taste for spirits than I thought. The ale up here is actually good. Orzammar ale tastes like dirt in comparison. Probably because they put dirt in it. Go figure. I don't know. Maybe eventually. I got offered a spot in the human army. And not as a mascot either. You know, these humans aren't bad for all their long legs. Maybe, for a bit. Talk to me in a year or so when I'm bored, and maybe I'll think differently. Ah, well, enough babbling. That pot-bellied son of a whore Tegan said I'd pass out before drinking an entire barrel of pickle juice. I aim to prove him wrong. Been good traveling with you, Warden. Don't get lost in the shuffle now.
Alright. Guess that's everyone we want to talk to. We could talk to Sten, but like I said, we were never really close to him. We were only close to Morrigan.
Are you ready, my lord? The crowds outside are getting restless. Right. I'll take you there now. Follow me.
The months that followed her coronation, Honora proved herself an adept ruler. Trade agreements with other lands quickly brought new funds into the royal coffers, and with them, the queen saw the capital rebuilt. The army was restored, laws were passed to encourage freeholders to produce sufficient harvests, and plans were conceived for a university. As years passed, Honora continued to rebuff the advice of Ferelden's nobility, requesting that she remarry. Though prospective suitors from either nations visit Denerim from time to time, the Queen's only comment is that all of them fall far short of the bar she measures them against, that of her father. Rumors that the Urn of Sacred Ashes has been found, and that it was used to heal Arl Eamon of his poisoning, circulated in Ferelden in the months following the Darkspawn defeat, slowly at first, and then with growing frequency as the Grand Cleric failed to deny them. Some years later, the Chantry announced that the resting place of Andraste's ashes had indeed been found. They were located, however, in ruins that were also the lair of a high dragon, thus proving too dangerous to approach. Many made demands to secure the ashes so that followers could undertake pilgrimages to partake in their healing powers. Following numerous failed attempts to deal with the dragon, the beast finally flew off to find another haven. But leaving the mountaintop sanctum in ruins, an excavation found no traces of the urn. People began to doubt that the ashes had ever been found, while others claimed that a cult of Andraste's followers stole them from the temple. Still others say that the Maker himself removed the urn, deeming mankind unworthy of it. For now, what happened to the urn is simply unknown. Following months of grim effort, the Templars cleared the last remaining spirits from the Circle Tower, making it safe to rebuild a home for Ferelden's Circle of Magi. Rumors of what happened increased the common folk's distrust of mages, and more than one young apprentice claimed to encounter mages thought long dead still wandering in the Fade. Once the tower was rebuilt, Knight Commander Gregoire stepped down from his post and retired to a life of private contemplation as a brother in the Chantry. His health failed over time, and after refusing treatment, he perished in his sleep. Knight Commander Cullen was said to be more strict and less trusting of the mages even than Gregoire was. He ruled the circle with fear. With the slavers shut down and the alienage, the lot of the city-born elves improved for a time. A food shortage years later forced Queen Honora to come down hard on elven rioters, an act not quickly forgiven, and a sign that tensions between the elves and humans were far from resolved. Shiani continued to be an outspoken member of the alienage community and in time became the new elder. That outspokenness earned her frequent trouble but served her people well. Arl Eamon returned to Redcliffe, beginning the long task of rebuilding. He found the village already bustling and eager to leave behind the memories of those terrible nights facing the undead. While Eamon planned to send Connor to the Circle of Magi for training, the boy grew strangely ill and the trip was delayed. Then one day, Connor simply disappeared entirely. After a frantic search, he was eventually given up for lost. His disappearance remains a mystery to this day. The Dalish elves prospered after the siege at Denerim, having earned much respect for their part in the battle. For once, human lands welcomed the wandering folk. The new keeper, Lania, was respected both amongst the Dalish as well as the Ferelden court. She was a voice of reason, and other Dalish clans were turned to her to help resolve disputes with human folk. In time, many of the Dalish clans moved to the new land provided for them in the south near Ostagar. Wary of their human neighbors, however, tension soon rose again, and only Keeper Lenya's leadership kept peace alive. In Orzammar, King Balin quickly proved himself a reformer. Trade with the surface lands increased and castle restrictions were loosened. The Castlists were permitted to take arms against Darkspawn in exchange for new freedoms. The first time in generations, the line in the deep roads was pushed back and a few tithes were reclaimed. Balin's reforms quickly found him enemies within the warrior and noble castes, however. And after several assassination attempts, the assembly was dissolved. The king then ruled alone. Some said as a tyrant, others said as a visionary, determined to drag Orzammar into the modern world. Dwarven mage Dagna ultimately completed her studies at the rebuilt Circle Tower on the surface. Eventually, she published a comprehensive theory of how lyrium vapors relate to the supply of magic. It gained a great deal of attention. This inspired mages from other parts of Thedas to establish a new circle of magi in Orzammar itself, one that had ready access to Dwarven lyrium and lies outside the Chantry's powers completely. The willingness of Orzammar to harbor apostates sparked outrage that began whispers that the Divine was contemplating a new exalted march. Although the Anvil of the Void was destroyed, why didn't I read all the text in the game? it takes too long. In fact, my mouth is already becoming dry. Although the Anvil of the Void was destroyed, rumors about its location crept into Orzammar. Years later, thanks to the defeat of the Darkspawn on the surface, a few determined smiths managed to locate the Anvil's remains. They examined the ruins of the Anvil, and upon returning to Orzammar with their findings, convinced the Shaperet to attempt to recreate Caradin's research. A new golem was created, bound with a spirit taken from the Fade. The golem immediately went insane, killing several Shapers before it was destroyed. The research was branded excessively dangerous and sealed away. Whispers of its existence circulated throughout Orzammar, however, and demanded among the smith cast to reopen Caradin's research refused to abate. As good as her word, Morrigan disappeared once the archdemon was slain. Someone of Morrigan's description was seen traveling alone months later, heading west through the Frostback Mountains, and she may even have been with a child. There was no word of her after that. With Flemeth dead, or at least gone, the chances of tracking her down were slim indeed. One cannot help but wonder, however, what became of the child. What were Morrigan's plans? These questions must remain a mystery for now. Both Enigma and the companions who helped defeat the Blight eventually scattered to the Four Winds, drawn either by personal duty or the call to further adventure. Circumstance dictated that they would not see each other again, at least for a time. Unfortunately, Alistair is not going to be joining us since he was executed. As the Blighted Lands began to heal and the Grey Warden slowly rebuilt the Order in Amaranthine, they discovered that the fight against the Darkspawn was not yet complete. Although the Horde was routed and had dissolved upon the Archdemon's death, many of the more powerful Darkspawn survived to organize roving warbands that preyed upon the land and upon each other. These warbands spread havoc, and some even journeyed west into Orlais and crossed the Shining Sea by the Deep Roads. They proved incredibly difficult to wipe out. But these are tales yet to be told. This tale ended when Enigma sank his blade in the Archdemon's head and destroyed it forever. It was not the last that Ferelden would hear of him, however. game basically just froze. Yeah, I don't really get it. It's so frustrating that it decided to crash right at the end. Like, did it even recognize that I beat the game? Yeah, it is a great game. One of these days, I definitely want to play Kingdoms of Amalur. And also Dragon's Dogma. Those are more action-oriented RPGs. I think it would be a lot of fun, though. I also want to play a Knights of the Old Republic one day. It's longer than you remembered it. Like it, but won't play it again. Simply too huge. After I get my gaming PC and, you know, can install mods and things like that, I might one day come back to it. It's really good. I think it's worth playing again, even after I beat it twice. But yeah, I know how you feel, Jerka. It is a really big game. And it has the more traditional gameplay style that's more like D&D. You just issue a command to fight and then they fight automatically. So it's not an action RPG. Alright. Nah, we're gonna call it a night for tonight. The Mass Effect games. Yeah, the only game I've beaten in that series is Mass Effect 2. One of these days, I definitely want to play all the games from the beginning as well. In any case, I heard Mass Effect 2 is the best in the series anyway. So tomorrow, I might begin Hitman Absolution, or I might just play a small game. You know, after these long streams of playing a game for a long time, I usually like to play like some small games before we get started on the next big game. When a game crash? I don't know. Maybe Chertka knows. So, I don't know. I guess I have to restart the computer, PS3, and see if this will work. 3 isn't bad. Mass Effect 1 looks like from another era. Yeah, I heard Mass Effect 1 is a pretty different game, but I definitely want to play it. Pretty good ending music. Very, like, it's not really appropriate for the game, but I like it. Alright, so I guess that's it. The first one's the most open? Okay. Yeah, one of these days I'll check it out when I get my gaming PC. Alright, so I'm gonna close up for tonight. I want to thank everyone for streaming with me. Thank you so much. And hope to see you all again tomorrow. Have a good night, everyone. Bye.